In order to build a full-fledged development environment in Neovim, you have to spend hours, no wait, years configuring your setup, step by step, plugin by plugin, suffer at the hand of mysterious errors, bang your head multiple times, go back to VS Code, then uninstall and cry yourself to sleep. Then, and only then, when you wake up, you'll have a partially working setup that you can write a bunch of code in and tell everyone that you're a cool kid now. That's what I've done for years, but this isn't the case anymore. It's 2025. Not only do you have Neovim core maintainers with kickstart projects to jumpstart your own Neovim journey, there are now full-blown Neovim distributions. A ready-made Neovim distro, including all the bells and whistles, with language servers, themes, auto-completions, debuggers, AI, fuzzy pickers, honestly, everything you can ask for and much, much more. But people still criticize this. Overkill, hidden configuration, bloated. How about you'd be the judge yourself? Because we don't all have years to wait, and honestly, if I had the luxury of Neovim users nowadays, I'd take it without blinking twice. So here it is, Neovim from scratch to absolute beast mode. We'll install, configure, launch, and cover the power that lies within. If you've been living under a rock for the past couple of years, let me introduce you to LazyVim, a Neovim distro, meaning a wrapper around it that doesn't only come with a bunch of utilities and plugins, but also carries a huge range of optional extras. These are updated on a weekly basis and have recently got a huge boost. So let's jump in, install it from scratch, just so you see how easy the process is and how wild the outcome. If you have a current setup, it's advisable to back it up by moving your .config/nvim aside, as well as local share, local state, and .cache/nvim directories. Since my config is committed to GitHub and lives in my .files, the .config is just a symlink. More about my .file setup in the video above. I'm going to delete nvim from .config and then, as advised, remove the local, state, and cache and other temporary files. Okay, it's go time. Git clone LazyVim starter to config/nvim, and that's pretty much it. There's a few files and a solid structure here that we're going to go through, but for now, let's just fire up Neovim. The first thing you're going to see is the lazy screen installing a bunch of plugins like Bufferline, Cappuccino Theme, FZFlua, GitSize, and other plugins that are almost considered a must these days. Obviously, it's all opinionated, but can be changed easily later. For now, let's let it finish, then restart Neovim to see the effect. And there we are. If you look at the bottom quickly, it says 4 out of 34 plugins are actually loaded, thanks to Lazy doing what it does best, lazy loading plugins in the appropriate event, leading to a blazing load time of just 25 milliseconds. I can tell you I've never reached that fast startup time, regardless of how well I thought I configured things. Okay, so we have everything set up. Now let's take a step back and fire up Yazi to view some file structure. Don't worry, there's a perfectly capable one that comes with Lazy, but we're taking it step by step. So we have a one-line init.lua file that loads config lazy. There's a famous lazy lock file that represents our plugin state, just like any other lock file you probably know. Now, lazyvim.json is where lazy gets interesting, and while it's quite empty right now, we're going to see it get filled up once we make changes. Under Lua, you've got config.dir for auto commands, keymaps, and other distro options, and plugins.dir holding example.lua file with Lazy's array of plugins, which, if you've already used Lazy in the past, maybe just as a package manager like I did, this should look very familiar. With that out of the way, let's jump back in and show the magic. While LazyVim by default comes with a useful startup dashboard, your first key for basically everything is leader key, which in my case and most others is space. Hitting it once will pop the lazy command palette, mapping keys from NeoTree for file exploration, through quick access to buffer switching, down to submenus for more buffer management options, code utilities debugging options, file, Git UI, and many, many more. For example, hitting F for file or find, and I also added a keycast in the bottom left corner so you can follow along. This pops the submenu for files. Here we can continue to our desired actions like E for NeoTree Explorer, which I can then use to explore the system like we've done with Yazi earlier. As you can see, buffer line on top indicates open buffers that we can later move between and use to work on multiple files. If you're not sold on buffers yet and work with Windows, check the video above, which may change your mind. The next most useful hotkey is leader space, or simply space space for me, which defaults to fcdflua with a fuzzy file picker, allowing me to get a quick glance into file structure, like you may know from using Telescope Envy. Don't worry, Telescope is also available here, but it doesn't come as the default option, which I'm not actually sure why. In any event, remember, space starts the main command palette, space space, and your files pop in a fuzzy picker. If you ever need the lazy menu, it's available as L in the menu, so leader L pops that up, where you can update, install, clean, and use all the lazy package manager features, including following up on which plugins are currently loaded and which are not. Okay, so we've got all that power in our hands with a single installation, but what if I want to make some tweaks? You may have noticed that I was trying to switch insert to normal mode using JJ, as I always do, but naturally LazyVim doesn't know about my very sensible setting, which I don't understand why everyone doesn't just do. Anyway, let's change some mappings. LazyVim already offers keymaps.lua so that we can have a place for these settings without wondering where it's best placed. I'll split my screen to find my old keymaps.lua at my old .files repository, and for now I'll copy the JJ setting alone. My first inclination was to copy the entire file, but as with other setups, I like to start fresh and consider I had probably accumulated unused mappings and bad habits, just like my buffer key mappings here, which are all mapped with a T prefix from the past where I was used to managing tabs instead. Restarting Neovim again, and I don't know if the notifications above annoy you as much as they annoy me, but luckily these are coming from Fox Notifications, which is also the author of LazyVim. So we were blessed with a notification manager. Leader and U opens the UI options, allowing control of animations, background color schemes, and many other visual options, including, yes, dismissing notifications with N. So leader and U does the trick, and whatever notifications on the screen disappear immediately. When it comes to buffers, Lazy comes with a bunch of options. Too many, actually, so pick one and roll with that. You can pop a buffer explorer in Neotree, and while there are lots of options in the buffer menu, I found myself using leader BB to go to the last buffer. If you have more than two, or would just like to scroll through existing buffers, the default and super convenient mapping for that is square bracket and B to move to the previous or next buffer using opening or closing bracket respectively. You may know brackets from using the great T-Pope's Vim Impaired plugin, or the modern option mini bracketed, which is also what LazyVim using, and I've covered specifically in the mini plugins video up here. All of LazyVim's default mappings can be of course found in a nice table in the docs, and I suggest going through it at least once to see what resonates with you and match your workflow. At this point, after additions and other configs, my LazyVim stands on 40 milliseconds startup time, which considering everything it does so far is very impressive to me. But I'm not done. Bells and whistles are nice, but we need real-life scenario. So I'll open my actual work project where I'm building another Kubernetes operator to support high-scale workloads, and here's one of my Golang-based controllers which I'm adding some code to. But wait, the syntax looks okay and it's highlighted, but that's pretty much it. I don't see any errors or sign of an LSP. How about we solve that with LazyVim? Well, let's start by looking at the initial Lazy plugins array that LazyVim comes with. TreeSitter is installed with lots of basic languages, which explains some of the syntax highlighting and other code suggestions I've seen, but Golang is not only absent, but I'm also missing a bunch of other plugins that I've been using as a Neovim Golang environment, and I want them. Time to look at LazyVim's extras. From within the editor, you can find it in the dashboard when LazyVim starts up, or call Lazy Extras at any point. You'll see a pop-up window with lots of extras waiting to be installed as mini packages. I'm even getting a short list of recommended options on top, like the JSON package, Markdown, and TOML for whatever reason. And as you can see, in blue, every package contains a few plugins that work in tandem to create a language-supporting environment. Let's look for Golang, and there it is. Lang.go comes with Mason, mini icons, Neotest, DAP for debugging, and LSP config, of course, and many more. Under extras, you'll find parent groups like AI, coding, and others. Since we're after a Golang environment, I'll pop the lang section, revealing endless options from Angular and Ansible for you old school DevOps guys, through Docker, Elixir, heck, even new shell scripts are supported. I'll find Go, where we can see everything that's included together with the default configurations, should we want to tweak these later. For now, back to Neovim. Hit X to install, to which LazyVim responds with the feature being enabled and awaiting a restart. Let's follow its lead, stuff are happening in the background, and as soon as it's completed, I can already see GoPLS, the language server, pops an error for my badly positioned variable declaration. Just to refresh your memory, mini bracketed here also supports any diagnostics by using bracketing D or bracketing E if we want to scroll through errors specifically, like I'm doing right here. In addition to supporting Golang with the LSP, here's a nice addition I've never had, showing the asserted variable type inline as ghost code, like here where X is assumed to be an integer, Y is a string, and Z is a float. Similarly, code suggestions here are added and help with auto-completion when I want to use my variables, making things simpler and speeding up coding process. Now here's another mapping I've never used. Saving files had always been double capital W for me, where lazy comes with a nicer option of using Ctrl S, like save. I'm only showing the option here just to highlight another feature, where upon saving the code, everything is formatted, so indentation is fixed and in my case, empty lines are removed altogether. I want to stress out again how important it is to go through the list of mappings, where I found gems like the mapping for creating a comment above or below line using GCO or GC capital O, or get this, leader FT to pop a terminal with the current working directory just like you do with your typical IDE. Now that's not my style and I rather use Tmux for that, or better yet, my Tmux plugin Floaks to pop a floating terminal, but nevertheless it's a valid option, and if you're curious about all the terminal options when working with Neovim, check out the video above, which I made especially for that. Moving on, with sweet gems of LazyVim, check out the scratch buffer that pops with leader and dot, allowing you to test piece of code on a scratchpad without abusing your project's files. And look how the LSP generates code completion for an entire web server responding to my hello function. This isn't AI, you see here, it's pure code suggestion, and don't worry, we'll get to AI, LazyVim supports all your favorite code agents just as well. But before that, for those of you who are wondering, what about Git operations? And yes, I have the video up here covering all your Git options, but Lazy simplifies life. Leader G for Git, where there's Git blame, browse, commits, status, and lazy Git. Now, while I never used Neotree as my personal preference for Git status, I find it to be quite nice to use. Keeping the same visual theme of LazyVim, it pops in a similar fuzzy picker window like the file explorer, and staging, unstaging files is as easy as moving them to the left or the right, as well as resetting them and other operations. Now, is this better than having my beloved NeoGit replaced with other mainly viewing options? I mean, GC, which I've always been using as Git commit, now suddenly pops a window with Git commits, like a log. I'm not sure about that yet, but to cover for that, as mentioned, LazyVim has a hammer integrated to solve all your Git needs and more. LazyGit, surprisingly, not developed by Falk, is one of, if not the best Git terminal interfaces, and it's now officially integrated into LazyVim. This way, staging, committing, searching through history or branches is all doable from one central location, which, if I'm honest, makes an amazing experience. Now, if LazyGit is good enough for DHH, which actually came on LazyGit's author show speaking about how he enjoys the tool, it's sure as hell good enough for me. With everything that LazyVim comes with, the ease of adjusting it to my needs, which as you've seen is close to zero, makes me want to keep it that way and don't go all too crazy with custom configurations. It already comes with my favorite plugins integrated to its core, like Mini Pairs and Mini AI, and no, not that AI, just a better text objects list. What I'm saying is, LazyVim is the full package, almost no sacrifices, not in capabilities, and surely not in performance. Now, I still see variability in startup times, this one took 29 milliseconds, so let's load up a few more extras you've all been wondering about. This time, it's like a candy shop, I'm getting everything I want. Markdown, check. Mini surround, check. Mini files, you're about to see real power, check. A JSON package, sure, check. Helm files, sure. I come from DevOps after all. Let's throw that into YAML too, because how else will I be able to enjoy Kubernetes? And while Lazy is installing everything now, you can see the added key mappings in purple. For example, for surround, they all start with G. Not my personal preference, and a great place to present how we can make changes to a plugin mapping in the right way so that they reflect in the menu of options too. So with Neovim loaded again, and notice that it's now in 27 millisecond load time, thanks to Lazy, nothing major had changed when all these new additions stay unloaded. Let's open up some files like a good Kubernetes YAML to show YAML-based LSP errors, which, if I'm honest, I've never seen or bothered with before. It's super cool and helpful, especially for a Kubernetes developer like myself. Remember, I promised some real power? Check mini files, one of my favorite recent discoveries. Since it's added as a Lazy extra, it also shows up in the menu if you hit F for files. We now have M for mini. Mini files, for those of you who aren't familiar, is a file manager letting you control files by deleting, renaming, adding, and viewing, like all.nvim or some of the NeoTree capabilities, just better. Let's use it to see how to add the plugins mapping following best practice. I'll add a new file under plugins called surround.lua. Once ready, hit the equal key and approve the action to create a new file. That's it, surround.lua is ready. Let's follow the config options. I'm heading over to LazyVim docs, and under configuration recipes, there's the surround options we'd like to change. These can live in the example.lua file that Lazy come with, or as a new file, which is how I like keeping things easier to find and work with. We'll return the object per Lua's conventions, and now instead of using GSA to add, which as you can see, GSAIW, meaning in word, and then any sign will wrap the word. I'd like to change G to my leader key. Now, leader SA pops a menu of surround options. How cool is that? You can surround a line, next or previous word, character, and more. Let's also change the delete action to use leader and show why I love mini plugins so much. Check out the cool next object, allowing for leader SD and Q, calling for surround delete and Q for quotes, stripping any kind of quotes from the word I'm working on. There are more options which I enjoy a lot, like taking action on the next finding or previous, but we're not here for text objects. Check out the description or my channel for the video covering that. Meanwhile, Docker files get their own LSP with code suggestions, error corrections, and other options previously only reserved to real languages. Needless to mention, commenting code, up until recently a plugin you had to bring on your own, comes here integrated as core essential. Remember that lazyvim.json file we've seen upon installation? Well, look at it now with all the extras added to it, tweaking the configuration and following versioning of config that has changed. Before wrapping things up, I know many, including myself, are wondering about AI and how it integrates in. Should you get your own code completion? What if you prefer Copilot over Codium or your own model? Since GitHub's Copilot is free now, I'm happily going back to integrating it. So let's first add this as a LazyVim extra under api.copilot entry, which also comes with auto-completion and other supporting plugins. With that installed, the integration process is rather simple. Just follow the URL and use the one-time code, authorize the integration, and that's pretty much it. Now, with a simple comment saying, let's create a function that grabs all the pods from the cluster, Copilot introduces a new reconciler function, which if you've been working with Kubernetes operators, you can see how the model picks up the context in which it should work and doesn't only create a function, but also builds it correctly according to how the controller works. Lastly, LazyVim comes with many, many settings that you can change to persist or on the fly, like heading over to the UI section with leader and you, and then enabling cool features like dimming with capital D. That keeps only the focused bits of code in your eyes. You may know this feature from another famous fork plugin called Zen Mode, which is also optional from within LazyVim. What I'm trying to say is you can use LazyVim as is, and as you've seen, it works out of the box. But there's a lot to explore, key mappings, extras, additional configurations of core setup, and more. Under the util section, there's project management add-ons, Octo, .files, Git UI, REST client, and many others. There we are. Now you're ready to go, but Neovim is just one element of mastering a workflow. Combined with Tmux, the two are unstoppable, so make sure you have Tmux from scratch to propel yourself into the world of terminal multiplexing, controlling your way beyond just an IDE. With these two combined, you really are a cool kid. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.